Hello, I'm pleased to welcome Professor Anna Falanga from Hospital Papa Giovanni the 23rd from Bergamo, Italy. Today we are going to be discussing the mission of the European Thrombosis and Hemostasis Alliance. Welcome, Professor.
Welcome.
So, Anna, tell me, what is the European Thrombosis and Hemostasis Alliance?
Well, the European Thrombosis and Hemostasis Alliance is an alliance, actually, of 23 countries, European countries, at least so far. Others may be joining later on. And this alliance was established in 2017, generated by the ISTH Task Force on Public Affairs. And it was launched officially in the European Parliament on the 3rd of May of 2018. And we had an event there. And it was also the occasion to launch the consensus statement of the alliance on that day. The goal of this alliance is to reduce the burden of thrombosis in Europe and also raise the awareness on clotting and bleeding disorders. And finally, we think that this is a European, a pan-European challenge, and which requires an EU concerted action.
So if you can you say a couple of words around how thrombosis and the topic of patient safety is related?
Well, thrombosis is a contributing factor in 1 of 4 deaths. And therefore it is very important, I say in Europe, but it is all over the world, but ETHA is working in Europe, so I say it's important that in Europe there is an increasing awareness, and it's important that the EU governments improve the knowledge, the diagnosis, treatment, prevention of this disease, and incorporate this in patient safety programs, harmonizing that in all European countries. So this is what I would say in few words. Then if you want me to say more about the reasons why we had this alliance and why we want to reach out the public officials. This is because thrombosis is contributing to the global burden of a disease in the world and in Europe, of course. And it's a leading cause of morbidity and mortality in hospital patients. And venous thromboembolism occurring in hospitalized patients is an important cause, is a leading cause of that and the disability. And the burden of the disease is increasing with aging. And definitely we are facing in Europe an increasingly growing aging population. So it is important to face this program, and it is important that the EU governments, the different governments that are in the European community, continues to invest in research to improve the performance, because this is not only thrombosis is a leading cause of morbidity and mortality in the hospitalized patients, but what is most importantly is that it's the first preventable cause of death in hospital patients. And we have developed effective tools for risk assessment and also measures to prevent this death, for instance. So it is important that these tools are incorporated in the healthcare system and to change the healthcare system and harmonize this all over the European countries, because there are some places are more developed than others not. They should be adopted equally all over Europe.
great information. We talked about thrombosis from a higher level. Maybe if we can just delve into one of the hot topics we're hearing a lot about right now, which is cancer-associated thrombosis.
Well, yes, cancer-associated thrombosis is a very hot topic because venous thromboembolism is a very important comorbidity of cancer, of malignancy, of the malignant disease. The cancer patients have a fourfold increase in the risk of having a thromboembolic event, venous thromboembolic event, compared to the non-cancer population. So this is important to prevent this because it is an important burden to the overall disease of these patients, and also it is difficult once it occurs to treat. Is more difficult because these patients are more prone also to bleeding complications, so the use of anticoagulant drugs is more complicated. So this is one of the most important issues right now, and for this reason the ETHA is also advocating for a cancer being one of the leading programs in the cancer in the research horizon research calls for grants. And also the ETHA is trying to strengthen the capacity of the ETHA members to apply successfully to the research call of European community.
So there's a lot of great information that the ETHA is currently doing.
Yes.
If individuals or organizations want to learn more about it, where would they go?
We have a website where they can find all the information, and it's etha.org. And everyone that is a representative of a thrombosis and hemostasis organization can apply and first get more information and then apply to become a member of this organization. We are trying to connect with the national organization, local organization, and also make alliance with other organizations that have similar finalities, like Health First Europe. They also are trying to go in the same sense. Also, we are trying to make a coalition with other groups and organizations that are working on other cancer comorbidities, for instance, or nurses organizations and patients organizations. So there is a lot going on.
Lots. Well, Anna, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much for taking some time today to speak about the ETHA. My name is Vin Caltavito, and that closes today's discussion around the mission of the ETHA. Thank you.